Listen, this guy right here, one of the coldest young, let me say it like this, storytellers. Coming out of Louisville, Kentucky. Ladies and gentlemen, we've had some conversations before. You probably heard of him. This is ESTG. Right here on the Ebro Show. It's Apple Music. Having a nice little sit down in an amazing facility. This is where you at now, bro. This is the path you on.
What's up?
You ready for this life?
If I ain't no minute.
It's too late.
Yeah,
it's too late.
Yeah,
it's too late. You got this collaborative project, Last Ones Left with 42 Dugg. Shout out to 42 Dugg. The weather and everything kind of sent things sideways. We was having some crazy weather, so we're going to catch up with him. But tell me about this project, how y'all have collaborated several times.
Yeah.
On your project, on his project, on Gotti's joint, y'all got something on there. But
yes,
how did y'all come together for a full collaborative project?
Me and Dugg just be in the studio a lot most of the times, you know what I'm saying? So we got so many songs together, it just makes sense for us to put something out together, you know what I'm saying? Proper, because both of us is, you know what I'm saying, artists in demand, I think, so. I think our fan base is like it, you know what I'm saying, in our general area, you know what I'm saying? It's like a tie, you know what I'm saying? Michigan and Kentucky, you know what I'm saying? So it just makes sense. And then me and Doug make good music together. I think everybody like
it. Yeah. You know, you don't do a lot of interviews on purpose, you know? And I appreciate you taking time for us, man.
What's up?
How much material do y'all have recorded?
A lot we got.
Like, you could put out multiple albums at this.
Yeah, we probably could put out another one right now. We got a lot of music.
When y'all say Last Ones Left, what does that mean?
It's just like, I feel like it was it's like a group of people, you know what I'm saying? That's a certain type of way. And it feel like it ain't a whole lot, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, it ain't just speaking up. Me and Doug specifically, but you know what I'm saying? Like the group of us and large part of us.
Certain type of fabric.
Certain type of people, certain type of, you know what I'm saying? We the last ones left. Like, it might not be no more of like us after, you feel me?
Is that why y'all enjoy recording so much together? Because both of y'all are new in the music business, the industry.
Yeah.
You know, have you come across a lot of motherfuckers? You just like, I can't. I mean, y'all cool and whatever, but I can't. We can't do business together.
Doggy probably done came across, because he done been in a little bit longer. So I feel like I ain't really ran across too many people, but it be, I don't know. I feel like they catch my drift. It be more so me, I think. It's like, they think they with me, you know what I'm saying? And then they get with me and I ain't as... You know what I'm saying? My conversation might not be as hot. You know what I'm saying? You know how it be. I don't know. You know how it be. Like, it's just, they think I'm like them or however they is, you know what I'm saying? And I don't be. So then they just be catching my drift. I don't think it's nobody. I don't know. I feel, I don't look in no type of way. So it's whatever. You
know
what I'm
saying?
Your own page. Yeah, I'm gonna do me. But you know what I'm saying? I think I be looking for friends. I ain't looking for no friends, you know what I'm saying?
Tell my stories and get my money.
Yeah, I got my folks, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
We came in like this, we gonna go out like this. I ain't trying to make no long life rap buddies. If it is what it is, but I think you just looking for friends.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Which is cool, but I ain't doing that.
Everybody shines together, the EST part. Tell me about that acronym and the team, because you're featuring some people from the team on here.
Probably the most successful music label, you know what I'm saying, entertainment group, whatever, to ever come from Kentucky. It is, you know what I'm saying, collectively. You know what I'm saying? Just so happen we black, we, you know what I'm saying? So, of course, they be trying to make it something that it ain't, you know what I'm saying? But you can't go against, like, we really a real music, you know
right.
what I'm saying? Like a real company, you know what I'm saying? Like we make money, our company makes money, you know what I'm saying? It's just what it is, you know what I'm saying? Like same way like how Gotti got CMG, you know what I'm saying? And all the other, you know what I'm saying? Birdman, Cash Money, you know what I'm saying? Just how all the other people had their imprints. This is just our imprint from where I'm from, you know what I'm saying?
How significant what you guys are doing, what Jack Harlow's been able to do.
Yeah, Jack, that's my guy, Jack.
Yeah.
Jack, he really played a big part in my career, I feel like.
That Route 66.
He just believed in me, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, when people ain't get it, like, I won't say I wasn't around the right part of, like, the industry yet, you know what I'm saying? So, like, I couldn't go Jack's way, mm-hmm. but he tried to take me his way, you know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? Like,
he saw
still
it.
In the streets. Yeah,
he saw.
He tried to take me his way, like, still in the, you know what I'm saying? So, I love Jack. Jack, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Jack's the GOAT, the coldest, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
They see Jack, they can't f*** with Jack. They know they can't f*** with Jack. And Jack know they can't f*** with me, so we should.
I want to play that Route 66, too. That was the first time I heard, you know, that was the first time
was
I had heard you. It was on Route 66. I
he
was
got
like,
a lot of songs like that.
I was like, wait, hold up,
banger.
Who is this?
Yeah, he got a lot of songs he ain't put out that's cold that I
Jack Harlow sitting on heat.
Man, what? Jack could drop a tape with me and him. He is.
When's that gonna happen?
Man, Jack gonna, we gonna, I'm gonna, it's me. I had to get my stuff together, but. It's time now, so it ain't gonna be looking like it don't look like he's just doing his boy a favor. I'm ready now.
Got it. So you wanted to get your game up to make sure you was ready for the moment.
Yeah, I had to get my. It ain't, you know what I'm saying? My boy, he's a star. He was a star, been a star.
Mm-hmm.
So I just had to get my shit together, and now I'm ready. You know what I'm saying?
That's all.
Man, Jack, going.
Happy for y'all, man. You got a favorite off Last Ones Left today?
Strictly for the Gangsters. My big brother, Red. Mm-hmm. Rest in peace.
That's a homie right there.
My brother right there. Can y'all see him? Strictly for the Gangsters. Right here, Strictly for the Gangsters. You know what I'm saying? That's my favorite song. Red ain't no rapper or nothing. He just, you hear me? He made that. And the day he died, he was like, when I'm about to get this song mixed, I made a song, I'm about to get it mixed. And I had been talking to him like that whole morning. Give me dad or whatever. But that's my favorite song. It's hard than no bitch. He ain't no rapper. He sound like he been doing it forever.
Mm-hmm. So he had that skill just built in.
He just is good at everything. He was him. He's, you know what I'm saying? He just, everything he did was, you know what I'm saying? That's what you, it's how you want to do it. That's
right.
How you supposed to do it. Strictly for the game.
You know, we don't do these type of sit-downs where, you know, we rent out the whole set for too many artists. So I hope you know that, man, you make some special things.
They ain't let me smoke my black, though, so it ain't.
It ain't official?
Uh-uh.
It ain't.
If they would have had Wayne or somebody up, they'd have let him have a backwood. And then wouldn't nobody said nothing. It's straight, though.
Yeah, that's where you. That's how you want to be. You want to just be like, nah, I ain't doing no interview unless I can smoke my black.
Yeah, I'm
that's
trying
it.
To get the Wayne stats. He do what he want. That's what I'm trying to get to. They don't even say, they don't even think about saying that. They going to let him rock out.
Yeah.
That's what I'm trying to get to.
The production team got 42 Dugg on the FaceTime. We had some flight mix-ups, but we're going to big him up. Show him love. Yo, Dugg.
What's happening?
Look.
Where you at, bro?
What's all that going on?
Where you at, bro?
No, we hanging out, man. We rented a whole crib. Look.
Man, I haven't heard about that.
You know, I let him buy the house for this. I let him buy the house for the interview. They gave me 5,000. I let him set up to sit in here.
I'm hurt y'all doing this
about
y'all baby.
Man, they gonna get a close-up on you.
Now we celebrating this album, Last Ones Left, man. We wanted to get you on and show you love, man, and just say, man, it sound good. Play some music.
What's your favorite song? I told him I already know your favorite song.
My favorite song, probably
Thump. If I was wrong, I was gonna leave. I just said that. You playing that when you wake up in the morning. That's when you get up, that cut on in your hair.
Okay.
See, I told you we got some bad motherfuckers, though, that I told him we got another album.
Show.
They got another album.
I swear to God.
Man, 2 more million.
we drop the other one next week. Let's send that in the air.
5 million.
When they run up 5 million streams as soon as this drop, y'all dropping another album within 2 weeks.
$5 million.
Oh, $5 million.
Yes, dollars. I just need two. I got something dollars. I got to do real quick. I just need 2.3. I got something I got to take care of. And then we figure out the rest.
Need to go platinum first week.
Yo, Dugg, we're going to let you go, man. Thank you for your time, man. And love on this album, man. Good work. Good work.
I appreciate it, man. Y'all, I appreciate y'all.
With us. Always. Love you, call me. Call me later on. Love you.
Love you too, bro. Be safe.
All right, one. We just got confirmation that there is another ESTG 42 Dugg album as soon as the label send over $5 million. And after the label sends over the $5 million, then we're going to get the ESTG 42 Dugg second album, and then we're going to get the Jack Harlow collaborative project. That's for the city. That's going to turn the city upside down. Jack, now, does anybody else know about this?
It ain't on Jack. It was on me. Jack been ready. I just had to get, you feel me?
Yeah.
Everybody know.
Like, in Louisville, there's expectation that there will be a collaborative.
Jack's partners, they probably heard. They heard, you feel me? They know that me and Jack got a lot of songs. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It ain't no, like, it ain't no expectation or nothing like that, but Jack got a lot of songs to where Jack always wanted to, you know what I'm saying? He always wanted to, like, he wanted to go on tour one day and mm-hmm. he wanted to put, you know what I'm saying? I just had to be able to fulfill my end of the, you know what I'm saying, before, so it can make sense for him.
That's another reason why I wanted to have this sit down too, because I hear in your music that you care about the craftsmanship. How it sounds, how you sound, what you talking about. You know what I mean? Like, you care about making sure that you put and you contribute to the game of music in an important way, in the best way you can. Mm. Like, I hear that in...
I think a lot of people think this, like, that I'd be, like, hounding over my shit. I don't think I'd be, like...
It comes naturally.
Yeah, I don't be going back and changing nothing or nothing. So, like, how y'all heard, it's how I had made it that day. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go back the next day and be like, I need to touch this verse up or make this better. Or even if sometimes I might mess up on a word, I just leave it how it is just because...
Because it feels real.
Yeah, just the feeling of it, you know what I'm saying? Like, because anybody, I don't know, I feel like you can be rhyming and just be a good rhymer, and you know what I'm saying? But it just, sometimes it'd be a certain... I don't know how to describe it, like a certain...
Look, some people got it.
Yeah, it's like you just want to hear somebody. Somebody you just want to hear.
Yeah.
You feel me? Like, I like to think of it like a nigga, like, everybody couldn't... You could have did the same shit that, like, Martin Luther King did, but his voice, the way he projected his voice, you feel me?
He had it.
It just made people connect with him differently, you
That's
feel
right.
me? It probably was another... Just as qualified, just as...
Yeah.
But he just couldn't put that... It on, like, you know what I'm saying?
The voice.
He could the voice, you know what I'm saying?
So singers too.
For sure. It'd be some singers who, you know what I'm saying?
You can sing the notes, but you don't feel like this person over here.
Like that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And I could sing too, throw it out there. But yeah.
Oh, you got vocals?
No.
We're going to learn about that later.
For sure. But yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Motherfuckers, you got to be the one. You got to be one of the last ones.
EST Vandross coming soon.
Man, how did you know that? I'm like, told you something, man. Yeah.
Coming soon. I want to get to this Never Scared, because you got one of your peoples on here, EST the Mike. Yeah. Tell me about this track 15.
Ski Mike. Never Scared. Ski Mike ain't no rapper for real either, but he is now, though. But I got a studio at my house. He was just in there. I forgot. I think I came upstairs next morning type. He's like, I made a song. I'm like, man, you know how it is. You're like, man, let me hear it. You feel me? Because I ain't expecting this from Ski Mike. You feel me? Ain't nobody expecting D Mike to rap. Or, you feel me? Just be trying to rap. But he played it. I'm like, now he's playing it. We sitting in like the little, you gotta know how to have, like, we sitting in the outside room from the studio room. You know what I'm saying? So I'm hearing it like, damn it. I'm like, hold on, run that back. And it was hard. I'm like, oh, I might put a verse on there. You feel me? And then he been making his songs ever since. He got some shit coming out. It's going to be hard. You know what I'm saying? And he's doing it by himself. He ain't, you know what I'm saying? He's trying to make a whole song just him. You know
so he working on it.
He's working on it, you know what I'm saying? And so, you know what I mean? I think more is going to fuck with it. I know they fuck with it. Never scared, you know what I'm saying?
When you look forward, you know, a lot of money starting to come in. You uplifting your brothers that you came in with.
That's Freaky Shines. One time with Free Zelski, Free Reek, Freaky Reek, Easy, Bopper, Fat Boy, Don Juan, Free Don Juan, Bopper, Lil Scary, Fat Man, Big Night, Free Big Night. It's a lot of niggas, you feel me? But I do more than just say free my niggas. I pay lawyer fees, and, you feel me? Send money in that place and take care of kids like that. So niggas know what's going on, you know what I'm saying? Free Shiners, though. And we ain't just saying that on no raps, you know what I'm saying? Free Mad, you know what I'm saying?
Free the Shiners.
We ain't just saying that in no raps, man. Free Mad.
Last ones left. When you think about the future and
free
you think...
Free Spit.
Oh.
Free Spit, my little brother, Free Spit. We got to get all of them in there. I'm like, it might keep coming to me.
Yeah, when you keep remembering them, shout them out.
Free Spit.
You know, people don't get into this to not change the lives of their loved ones. You know what I mean? To not figure out how they're going to leave something behind for their children and, you know, future generations. When you think about the future... What's that look like for you right now? Like today, you know, tomorrow might be something else, but what are those priorities on that list to make sure you get done when you have the opportunity to do it?
I understand what's going on with myself, you feel me, and what's around me. So I always make sure I got something for you. If I love you, you know what I'm saying, I care about you, I got something for you, you know what I'm saying? And I came through every time, so all my loved ones and people I care for, they know, you know what I'm saying? If they don't got it, they can get it, you know what I'm saying? So I think that's what it's about. And then people might not understand business and like that, the way I understand it. So me coming to you like, hey, here go $20,000, let's start a business.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? It might not work like that. I might have to actually get in and then get hands on and get it started and then give it to you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I think God blessed me with enough to be how I am, to be able to do like that. You know what I'm saying? Whether it seem like a waste of time or hard to do, you know what I'm saying? That's what I'm made for. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So as long as I can just feel I got to stay focused on that, making sure I can, you know what I'm saying, put on for my people, make them happy, and being able to, you know, make sure to take care of them when they need it or when they don't need it, you know what I'm saying? That mean the most to me, you feel me? Stay free, you know what I'm saying? Stay alive.